Pilots, Drain Man here, and today I got a very special video. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to get your TBS Fusion out of bootloader mode. If you have got your TBS Fusion stuck in bootloader mode, I'm gonna show you how to get it out of there. It was hard to mimic this problem, but now that I have, I can show you how to get it out of there. There's two parts to this. The first thing is, if you had version equal to or greater than 0.28, then this wouldn't have happened because there's already been a resolution to it that's built inside of the firmware. If you have a version that is under that, so 0.27, 0.26, anything before 0.28, then you have the possibility of this happening. There's one thing you need to do. You need to try to plug it and see if the TBS Agent X is responding. If it is not responding, or it is responding but you can't get out of bootloader mode, I'm gonna show you how to fix that today. Okay, so moving forward in this step does not matter what you had going on, but there is two things that matters. And one is, would it respond when you connected it? Or two, would it not respond when you were connecting it to the TBS Agent X? So before you do this step, try to plug the TBS Agent X in right here on your PC and see if it responds. If it does not, or if it does, it doesn't matter. I will help you with that step in a moment, but you just need to take note of it before you do this. All right, so what you need to do now is you need to go ahead and heat up your soldering iron, and then you need to get a little bit of solder. Position the TBS Fusion module facing you just like this. So you see your screen, you see the little wavy antenna right here, and you've got your two SMA connectors on the left. Go ahead and rotate 90 degrees, and then you are going to take this very first pin and you are going to solder it to this shell right here. I know, that's scary, but this shell right here is actually ground, and all you're doing is shorting this to ground, and that will solve your problem. Now don't jump ahead without me. You need to go ahead and finish the video so that you know exactly what to do, because there's still another part to this. So let's go ahead and do this part now. And what we'll do is we'll just take a little bit of solder, and we will stuff it in there and bridge these two together. All right, gonna need a little bit more. All right, now I want you to be sure, be double, triple, quadruple sure that you did not solder too many pads together. Double check your work by putting your multimeter in continuity mode. And that's when you hear that sound, and you're gonna touch this case and you're gonna touch this pad. All right, so we've connected it. Now, to be sure that we didn't connect the next pad, we'll touch it like this. So here I am touching the case and double checking that I didn't touch this pad. And now you know that you have connected it properly. So did you answer yes or did you answer no to, does this respond to the TBS Agent X? If you answered yes, it does respond, then all you're gonna do is plug your USB in and go ahead and update to the next firmware. If you answered no, that means that you plug your USB into here and Agent X does not respond. You don't see it moving, you don't see anything happening. Then what you need to do is you need to hold down this button while you are plugging this in, and do not release it for the entire process of the flashing. All right, let's go ahead and do that now. All right, so let's go ahead and plug our TBS Fusion into the computer. For me, the answer was no. It was not connected, it was not responding. When I plugged this in, it did not respond to me powering this up, and nothing would happen. I would get no screen on my TBS Fusion, and I would get no lights, no indication, no anything. It was just completely dead and bunked. So what I need to do now is I need to go ahead and hold that button. If you answered yes, yours does respond to that, then do not hold this button. And I'm gonna go ahead and plug it in now. And now I can go ahead and click Manage, Firmware. And now I can head over to the firmware that I want to update. Whichever firmware you're interested in updating to, do it. Just make sure that you're getting above that 0.28. Actually, I don't even know if that's an option. Yes, it is. Make sure you're getting above that firmware. For me, I want to stay under beta, but I want to still have the newest firmware possible. So I'm going to go ahead and select this one, and then I'll go ahead and click update. All right, now once your update is done and complete, you need to go ahead and unplug it. Your TBS Fusion is now fixed. At least for me, I've already got a full screen. Everything seems to be fine. I'm gonna go ahead and unplug. All you have to do is go ahead and unbridge them. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. I hope that this video was helpful, and I will see you guys on the next one.